Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 10.3, Problem 3. This is Section 10.3, Problem Number 3. It says, Colleen's car cleaning center in Carver wants to test the claim that a new type of soap will help cars they wash dry faster. The average drying time has been mu equal 32.6 minutes. A sample of 16 cars washed with a new soap had an average drying time of x bar equal to 30.8 minutes, with a sample standard deviation of s equal to 1.6 minutes. Conduct a hypothesis test at a 5% level of significance to determine if the cars dry faster with the new soap. So this is a hypothesis test. There's a six-step process. The first step is state the null hypothesis. So we will have H sub 0, put a colon, mu. You'll have some condition of equality. Now in this case, we can go right ahead and put mu equals 32.6. Your null hypothesis will either have an equal to, a greater than or equal to, or a less than or equal to, depending on how the question is worded. It'll always have some condition of equality. Step two is state the alternate hypothesis. The symbol is a capital H with a subscript of 1. You put a colon. Again, you put the same mu. You put the same number, but there's going to be a different symbol between the mu and the number. Now, in this case, we want to see if the cars are drying faster so that the drying time is less. You want to test the claim that the average is now less than 32.6. So, now on to step three, determine what type of test we have. It could be a left-tail test, a right-tail test, or a two-tail test. And to see which type of test you have, what you want to do is look at the inequality symbol in your alternate hypothesis. It will be less than, greater than, or not equal to. In this case, it's a less than. The less than points to the left, so this is a left tail test. Which means our critical region will be on the left end of our graph. So, that was the third step, determining that it's left tail. The fourth step will be compute the value for t. Now we're going to compute t because we have to do our test based on the fact that we have the standard deviation of only the sample. If we happen to know the standard deviation of the entire population, then we would calculate z. But since we don't, we calculate t. The formula's almost the same. So t equals x bar minus mu over s divided by square root of n. So I'll fill in that formula and do the computation. T equals x bar. The value of x bar is given at 30.8 minus mu. Mu is given in the problem as 32.6 over s. S, the sample standard deviation, is 1.6, divided by square root of n. N is the size of the sample. So for this problem, our sample had 16 cars in it, a sample of 16. So the sample size, n, is 16. Don't forget the square root. That's sort of a common mistake. And now I filled in the formula. Now I can start the computation. So in the numerator, 30.8 minus 32.6 will be negative 1.8. And then in the denominator, I'll have 1.6 over 4. That square root of 16 is 4. And then I can simplify the denominator a little bit further. 1.6 divided by 4 equals, I can actually do it without the calculator, 0.4. If you don't see it or you're not really certain, just do it with the calculator. You'll see it's 0.4. So now the computation I have to do boils down to negative 1.8, don't forget the negative, over 0.4. And again, that you may or may not see without your calculator. So just run it through, negative 1.8 divided by 0.4 equals, and the calculator will tell you it's negative 4.5. That's our value for t. So now the next step, step 5, is determine what the critical value for t is. When do you go into the critical region where you're going to reject the null? So what we do is we go to the student t-chart, which is at the end of the homework assignment, and we look for our level of significance. 5% as a decimal is 0.05, so that's the column we'll go to, the 0.05 column. And the row we want will be one less than the size of the sample. Our sample has 16 items in it, so the row we want in the t-chart is 15, one less. That's what they call the number of degrees of freedom. The column is labeled DF in degrees of freedom, and you want to look in the 15 degrees of freedom row, intersect it with the 0.05 column, and you'll see it intersects at 1.753. Now, technically, the t-chart is set up so that you know that number for the right end. So what you're finding is the number for the right side of the t-graph. But because it's symmetrical, like the graph of z, the other end that I want for my left-tailed test, the leftmost 5%, is the same number except with the opposite sign. It's negative 1.753. So now, did my computation for t go beyond that number? It did by a lot. It went way past negative 1.75. Negative 4.5 is like off the graph even. So we've gone way into the critical region. So the last step, state your conclusion. My conclusion is going to be reject the null hypothesis. You've gone so far into the critical region, you're clearly going to reject the null hypothesis, which means the alternate is more likely to be true. Again, not guaranteed to be true. So our conclusion, we will say reject null, which means it's more likely that the new soap does make the cars dry a little bit faster when they've been washed.